During the war, you didn't know what was going to happen from one day to the next. Perhaps it made you appreciate life more.
Yeah. It's no bad thing, is it?
No, it isn't a bad thing. No. Definitely not.
I'd have that fear that, like, that kind of stuff, like, bombs could happen at, like, any time.
That's
daily.
That's
terrifying.
Yeah.
That's actually terrifying.
There isn't, on the weekend, I mean, it doesn't stop. It's,
in the forest,
it could happen
by what we've found out, it isn't, like, something that happened a huge amount, but still, that's the fact that, the, just the idea
but
of
the fact that it did happen,
yeah,
and then
it
could happen at any time, without war.
I lived in two worlds. I lived in the world of home and school, and the world of the forest. Outside school, without a school uniform on, in the gangs we used to run wild through the forest.
I was brought up in Sudi during the war. My mother worked in a factory and my dad was in the army.
Every cottage had a few chickens, or some of them had a pig, and you know, life was so different.
They had no facilities in those days at all, you know. I often think when I put my washing in, I just put the powder, press a button and off to go, you know. And I mean, it was a day's job to do any washing in those days, you know. We had gas downstairs.
Yeah.
And nothing upstairs. You used to have a candle upstairs.
Right. The fact that, like, shops and stuff weren't open on, like, a Sunday, and that if you, like, ran out of, like, supplies, like candles or anything that's really needed, you'd be like, what do you do? Like, just sit in the dark?
I guess you'd just, like, go to a friend's house or a neighbour to borrow candles.
It's weird that it was, like, ages ago, you know?
I guess they just didn't know any difference, so that was just what their life was like.
You bought this black material and,
had
to tack it, so that there wasn't a chink of light, because wardens came round every night, and if you had a chink of light showing, you were in trouble.
If you got to mischief, you had to stand out in the hall and wait until the headmaster come out and caught you. Then you had the cane. Like three on each hand.
A few years ago, me and my family decided it'd be a good idea to, like, get a cabbage, right?
Okay.
And, like, explode it by putting some. Explode the cabbage, right?
What
with? Some little explosives. I decided to film it in slow motion, it looked really cool. It's such a random story.
Did it look cool?
It did look really cool. Like, it just explodes and then it just rains cabbage.
People dug their own gardens and produced their own food stuff.
If somebody had got a doorstep, we'd sit on there and play jacks. And somebody had an old clothesline, the whole road would do skipping.
Oh, right, yeah. With a clothesline.
Yeah. And tag and things like that, you know.
We were up in a hay bale place. Where do they have hay bales?
Barns.
That's it.
Whatever.
Hay bale place.
Hay bale place. And we were playing a game with a friend, Frankie. He decided to be a flyless dragon.
A flightless dragon?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And jumped off a ginormous stack of hay bales.
But because he was flightless, he...
Broke his ankle.
God.
Funny, he was a
As it
flight
out,
dragon.
You know, you can't...
Yeah.
One of those dragons
he got them mixed
you know,
up.
One of those.
Thought he was a flying dragon.
And, of course, Hoogly Ponds, and I lived in there.
Right, yeah.
I more or less lived in there. And every now and again they used to have these functions on the pond, you know, okay. Diving and swimming.
Yeah.
I got photographs now of me in midair. I won a few medals at that, swimming and diving.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember being in primary school.
Okay, yeah.
And there was this massive tree. I think it was a pear tree. I assume it was a pear tree. Because there was we came in and went out on the field one day and there were a load of pears on the ground.
Makes sense to have pear tree.
Yeah. So, being children like we were, we decided that the best course of action was to throw them at each other as hard as ever we could.
Obviously.
And then I think one of the dinner ladies came over and got sideswiped by one. At which point we were sent inside and told to write lines. And I believe the line was, "I will not throw pears." And I've never thrown a pair since.
I was in my field, just like normally feeding the horses, as
you do.
Yeah. And then as soon as I'm about to feed them and put the hay down, one of them steps on my foot.
Oh.
And I fall over.
That was rude.
I know. I fall over and then this horse like runs away and all the other horses come towards me because I've got food. And they start like going around me and so I'm like trying to eat the food
that
from
me. That doesn't sound like a fun experience.
Yeah.
That sounds terrifying.
And then I had to like hop away.
I knew boys, in those days, if you took a bottle of pop back, Corona pop, the snap top, or a bottle of beer back or something like that, or jam jars, you could get the money back on them. The boys used to, I know, they used to go at the Seven Stars with beer bottles and get a threepence each. And the old landlord just stick them in the yard and they go around the back and take them and come and bring them around again the next day.
Me and my friends, Henry, Iris and my brother Charlie, were at this place called the Secret Forest. So it's like this woodland and like all tourists all go and there's like an Iron Age village and a cafe. And my friend's mum owned the cafe, well she didn't own it, she like worked there. So we could like go around all the places all the public weren't allowed to go. And we were running around, we had like massive swords and staffs, all these sticks, which we must look really stupid. And we were going around, going like, la 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 la,
like
we were some weird tribe. Running around, like mud all over us, because we'd been there all day. And this family came walking along, who were the public, and they were really, really posh. And like, there was his mum, she had like two little girls, who had matching wellies, like matching hair and matching clothes.
God.
And then they were attacked by some sort of tribal children.
And there was like this dad, he had matching green wellies to the sun, and all of the girls all had matching like flowery pink wellies.
Are you sure they're not robots?
It was horrible. Delightful. It was literally, and we were there like hiding up this hill, like behind a tree, like looking around even out of the bushes, and then like running down the hills and like following them around.
God.
Chasing the posh people.
Yeah. They had no idea we were there, and then when they did finally see us, they literally looked like we were some weird, like, they were looking at us like, oh my god, what are these weird children? Where did they come from? Do they live in the woods?
I can't remember hearing that the war was over. VE Day, I think, was in May. And then VJ was in August. In our street, well, we had a piano. And my father could play by ear. He could play anything by ear. And I can remember all sorts of people I'd never seen before. They were coming in into our cottage, crowding in. They'd have a bit of a sing-song. Most of them were very merry. And then off they would go, you know, and another lot would come in.
Yeah.
And this went on into the... Well, I fell asleep eventually. But it went on to the early hours of the morning. People coming in, going,
right.
Coming in, going, singing. And very, very merry indeed.
Well, I think we discovered that the war wasn't all about the fighting, that it wasn't all about the front lines. It was most definitely about what happened at home as well. And particularly in the first inning, I think we all sort of thought going into it that growing up in this in that environment would be very different than how it is now. But I think what we sort of discovered, what we discovered through this project was that it wasn't that different, that children were doing the same things then as we do now. And I think one of the most important things that this project sort of has achieved is that those stories from so long ago are remembered now, because otherwise they'd be lost. Thank you.